have some teams, you know, back out. You're going to have some old nines, some 1-8, say Batesville, Lakeside, and Little Rock Christian. Yeah, yeah. They're a one seed. And to be honest, nobody really knows anything until 8 o'clock tomorrow morning when they turn everything in. So it's really tossing.
This one's okay. Oh yeah, we've got another 20 minutes. Just test this out.
Okay, testing 1, 2, 3.
Can you hear me okay?
Yep,
good. All right, Bill will be on here with the submitted.
Okay. 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 Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Hello, test 1, 2, 3. Hello, test 1, 2. Hello, hello, testing 1, 2, 3. How's that?
You sound a little hot.
Hello, test 1, 2, 3, and Kevin.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8.
Okay, how about that? Is that?
Concession stand. Again, 50-50 raffle ticket benefits Project Graduation. All proceeds go to benefit your seniors this year. So step up and help out those kids have a good time this year. Thank you.
Wait. standing down the hall, listening to the call. Man's going crazy when boys are falling. And if I just anybody in that club, took every ounce of heart and sweat and blood. Get the Widows game day jerseys down the hall. Kings of the school, man, where the boys are fun. The list. Turn and face the stars and stripes. Fighting back their blood lines. Calling in the air around you. Serving on the ball. And it's stuck in heads and talking trash. Slinging by.
I went, yeah. Hey, you won't believe this. They called me and they wanted me to do a Zoom call this afternoon. And I said, okay. And so I get on there and Fox, they don't have their syndication office. They don't have any other studios here. But they're starting on first round of this. And they're going to syndicate. So their first really big project came out. So I'm on the Zoom call with Jay Leno. Jay Leno is going to syndicate a show. He's going to bring back the old Groucho Marx. That's your life. Next year, yeah. And he was talking about, but he was sitting there in the garage. He said hi to me, you know. He's got that antique car garage. And he's sitting there talking to just a group of us that were on there. And he was talking about, you know, they don't have a pilot made. So how it's going to work. And he's going to have the same guy, Brandon Marsalis. Right from Marsalis that was on with him on the Tonight Show, he's going to be on this too. So, yeah. I kind of think so. I think it'd be real good. Kevin's on here. You can say hi to Kevin. Did I give you that email, Kevin?
You did.
Okay.
Hello, Mr. Ferris. How are you? Oh, yeah, absolutely. I told Marty I did tons of play-by-play in Texas for like 16, 17 years.
Matt, you can text me. Text me real quick, Matt. Let me know that you're getting this. We're going to go on here.
Welcome, fans and Citizens Bank Field at Airedale Stadium. And tonight's conference matchup between the Farmington Cardinals and your Allen Airedale. While the Cardinals and the Airedales prepare for tonight's game, we invite you to enjoy our pregame activities. At this time, if you'll turn your attention to the 50-yard line,
that's what I'm talking to you right now. We're
going
to make this work. We're going to chit-chat a little bit during the radio commercial breaks and fill in the airtime. Yeah, I think we're going to do that. I think we talked about that. I think we make that work. No, yeah, well, he hasn't touched it. Matt? Ready, Matt? Okay. All right. We're about to go on here in just a second. Can you hear me okay? Can you hear me on the stream? Okay.
Let's give that one more time. We're getting ready to go on. The high school dance team. The dance team will travel tomorrow to Canada to continue their competition season. And they will also have a show off November 12th, 6 p.m. in the arena for those who are not going to be able to make it to state November 14th. Farmington High School and Alma High School are playing this game through an agreement entered into by both schools. The schools are members of the Arkansas Activities Association and abide by the rules and regulations as set forth by the association to maintain and improve high standards of good sportsmanship by their conduct and cooperation with other schools. The high school students performing here tonight are friendly rivals as members of opposing schools.
Hello everyone, glad to have you as we are coming to you live from Alma, Arkansas, and the finale for the 2020 season. My name is Marty Houston. I am filling in for Jimmy Haas this evening. He had to be away on emergency and also helping me fill in tonight for a long time team for the area. Kevin Taylor. Kevin, glad to have you along with us, sir.
You are an absolute sports radio legend in this area. You and Bill Ferris, so it's an absolute honor.
This is my first game for the season, and we're going to have the national anthem early on here, so we're going to take a quick pause for our national anthem and get that out of the way. We'll take a Mr. Bill. We're going to go ahead and take a quick break, and we will be back with our pregame, Alma and Farmington tonight from Airedale Stadium. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Next week they've got some tough matchups next week, but you say this is pretty much a toss up.
I think it's a toss up. Farmington, they played a lot of common opponents, obviously, but you know, the Alma team is 1-7. It's 2020. We've had COVID issues. You got a new coach, Rusty Bush, came in back in the spring, and of course, no spring practice, not really much summer practice. Really, he was kind of behind the eight ball, and they had a hard time trying to figure out who the quarterback was. It was Brandon Allen to start the season against Van Buren. They moved to Connor Stacey. He played some quarterback for a while. They switched quarterbacks again. They went to a really talented young sophomore, and now they've gone to back to a junior named Hunter McAllister, who is got some size, 6'4".
I'm showing 6'7" on
yeah,
here.
Well,
is he taller than 6'4"?
He's 6'7", yeah.
Okay, all right.
But you've got Hunter McAllister in at quarterback, and he's got some size, and had a really good ball game last week. They scored 5 touchdowns in the game against Greenbrier. He threw for 251 yards, and really that was their best offensive output of the 2020.
Okay. Farmington, coached by longtime head coach Mike Adams. I go back to the 80s, and Kevin and I were talking about this coming into this. He used to coach at Charleston before he went to Farmington, and he has been at Farmington. Gosh, I got to go back to the 80s when I would talk to him on a weekly basis there at Charleston. He's the athletic director, I believe, at Farmington as well, so he knows what's going on. He's a guy that's been around.
He's definitely been around the block. I believe he also coached for a time in Fayetteville and been in Farmington for a long time,
right.
And wanted to see the new field. And they got this brand new facility, and he kind of ushered that in. And nobody's saying this is his last year, but, you know, it's near the end.
Northwest Arkansas, when he went to Farmington, had not taken the
no.
field.
No.
And he has watched all the changes in Farmington over the years, and even there in his own school, and now with the new facilities that they have. So there you go. Well, we were talking about possibilities for Alma next week. And And you were saying, now, Jimmy Haas was telling me he thought
at this time we'll have the coin toss.
Possibility of his touch can just number one. So he thought it was more likely.
Well, you know, here's what's going to happen. Everybody can be in a playoff game next week if you want to be. And so the thought process is everybody's is in, but what's going to happen is everybody's not going to be in. So tomorrow morning, schools have until 8 o'clock a.m. to get with the AAA and say, hey, we want to play a playoff game. And so obviously if you're 9-1 or 10-0 or 8-2, you know, you're getting ready. But not, you know, so this includes everybody. A 1-7 Alma team is in that, you know, it's, everybody is on that list. So the thought process is not everybody is going to want to play a playoff game. If that happens, Alma's got a chance to go to three places, it looks like. Now, again, a lot of stuff can happen between now and tomorrow afternoon, but you've got Hot Springs Lakeside is a possibility. Batesville, Arkansas is a possibility. And Little Rock Christian. So there's so much that can happen between now and tomorrow.
Well, Farmington has won the toss, but they've deferred their decision to the second half, so they will kick off. And Alma will receive, they were represented out there by Josh Callahan as their captain tonight. He's a senior running back and linebacker for the Airedales. We're about to get this one underway as the two teams are ready to bust through the banners.
All right, Airedale fans, it's time to get up on your feet and join the Airedale band of Spears Squad to welcome your
Airedale! The bump spot for me, you know, here as we hit our bottom, we made it to this point.
Somehow we're playing football. You know, I've talked to a lot of teachers and a lot of administrators and coaches. A lot of folks didn't think we'd be here on September the 1st, and here it is November the 6th, and we're still in school.
I heard the same thing. I don't think they're going to get it done, you know.
And here we are. So hats off to all the schools, the admin, the teachers, kids, who got it done.
Absolutely. They made the adjustments along the way. The kids wanted it. They wanted to be playing. And they have found a way to keep it going. You know, they had the protocols. They had to forego some games here and there or readjust and play. Sometimes they've had to pick up a brand new opponent in some of these schools. So
some of these schools around the state, you look at Cabot, one Friday back in like mid-October, they were playing a school out of Tennessee. That's nuts. I mean,
I know they're looking at it a couple of times. They're like, we'll go down to Louisiana, we'll go down to Camden. You know, they were making the adjustments and again, this is what the kids really wanted. I mean, they were voicing their opinion. So
one thing about coronavirus, the clock doesn't stop. So you feel bad for the kids last spring that missed out on senior soccer, senior track, baseball, softball. It didn't happen. And so, these kids in the fall, volleyball, football, and cross country are very, very fortunate. And tennis.
Miles Harvey to kick off for Farmington. And it will be taken at about the 7, across the 10, the 15, to the 20, and down to the 23. And I'm going to have to get my
number four, Kevin Mills on the return.
That's Kevin Mills on the return. My old center fielder in Little League Baseball back in the day.
Baseball connection there. Yep. Okay.
Kevin Mills, a junior, plays a little receiver, plays some defense, and Alma's going to start this drive at the 22.
Okay. As we set for the first offering, they're going to mark it just shy of the 22. Out of the shotgun. Their quarterback, McAllister.
McAllister's pass.
Quick toss to the right side.
Brings up second.
And bounces incomplete. Have second 10 coming up.
Well, they're going to be keying on number 26, Logan Cronister. Early in the year, back on the last Friday night in September, he ran for 281 yards. And, of course, that's a single-game school record at four touchdowns in that game that the Airedales lost to Pea Ridge 35-28. He comes into the ball game needing 135 yards to reach 1,000. So he is definitely a threat, and you know that the Cardinals are certainly aware of number 26.
Hunter McAllister, big 6'7" quarterback. The receivers are right. They're going to go with the jet sweep. trying to sweep to the left side and losing yardage back to the, I don't think he got back to the to the line of scrimmage. Was Logan Carpenter. We were just talking about.
Yep, he's going to lose a yard. That's not good. So right off the bat, Alma's looking at third and 11. And last week, they put up some yards. In the first half, they scored four times. They went up and down the field. So this could be a big, big defensive stand for the Cardinals.
They ran Cronister out of the, Cronister out of the slot position. Empty backfield. Callister back with pressure. Pulls the ball down, and now he's going to be sacked back at the 8-yard line. I'm sorry, the 13-yard line is where they're marking, and Alma will have to punt it away.
Not a good offensive start, just not enough time to try to clear the receivers, so a good job in the secondary from Farmington to not allow that to happen.
Standing back at the goal line, punt is on their way, wobbly. We'll take an Alma roll, though, across the 50, across the 40, and out of bounds, they're going to mark it at the 37. And that's where Farmington will take
over.
Mark
Pascoe out of bounds at the 37-yard
line. That's a 50-yard punt, so nice job by your senior kicker. He's one of these kids. He's missed some time because of COVID. That's just it's one of the weird things about 2020. That's Dane Martin, your kicker, and also your punter. So this is pretty good field position for the Cardinals. Let's see what they do.
All right. Kind of interesting to see who they've got out there at running back as the handoff to the left side across the 40 to the 41-yard line. And that is going to be Ian Cartwright. Not right by that. Ian Cartwright
Ian Cartwright for 4 yards. That means that their go-to back, Caden Elsick, is in the protocol for a concussion. He's not playing.
That had been up in the air, and so they weren't. There was some uncertainty who the starter would be at running back tonight. There's a handoff left side, back to the line of scrimmage. Not much. They can bring up a third down for Farmington.
Gain of 2 on the play. Brings up third down and 4.
As they will mark it at the 43-yard line.
And they're going no huddle. They're trying to do the kind of the sugar huddle, they called it back in the day.
And third down. See if Alma's defense can hold on. Back now scrambling is the quarterback, Sutton.
He got it.
He's got the first down. They will rule him out as he crosses. Did they mark him across midfield? No, just beyond. I mean, he just got the first down. They are going to mark him at the 48. I was not sure where they marked him out of bounds at, but he did just get the marker.
Needed 4, and he got 5.
Sutton, a senior quarterback, 6 foot for Farmington. Man in motion, dual receivers to the left. Here comes the option pitch left side, spun at the 42-yard line, and now knocked out of bounds for a loss at the 36-yard line. Once again, this is Ian Cartwright. Cartwright is actually listed as a backup quarterback, and they've got him running back this evening. I was talking to a guy that has some kiddos that go to Farmington, and he goes to a lot of the Farmington games. Had a chance to visit with him, to get some homework on them, and he said, I'm not sure who they'll go with if Caden Elsick does not play. Back is Sutton, swing pass left side, caught, brought down just in Alma territory at the 49-yard line with the receptionist Colin Hummel.
Well, that's a nice open field tackle by Trey Fusiler. Another kid I coached in Little League back in the day.
There you go.
Yeah, Trey, a nice two-handed tackle, and it's going to be third down and about 8.
Another third and long coming up for Farmington. Sutton, empty backfield, trips to the right side. Long snap count. Low snap, now it's a quarterback draw, keeps it up the middle, across the 45, the 43, the 40, down to the 38-yard line, another first 10 And that looked like it was a design draw all the way, Kevin.
I think it was. And I was thinking that exact same thing. And he just kind of followed his blockers a little bit. Picks up some nice yards. And another, that's back-to-back first downs on this initial drive for the Cardinals.
Alma still trying to get him off the field. They've had him in a third and long twice now. Now they're going to run out of the straight I formation this time. New running back in the game. And they go with the fullback, who reaches the 35, and that is going to be about it.
Yeah, they're going to give him, they're going to call that the, probably call that the 34 just inside, so it's going to be a gain of about 3.
Once again, it was Cartwright. He was lined up as a fullback that time.
Every man on deck with the concussion protocol for the big running back, the starting back that's not playing tonight, Caden Ilsick.
Dual backs in the backfield. Fake handoff, slant pass over the middle, caught and then dropped as he was looking for Tate Pickens over the middle. Could not hang on.
Here's another third down and long, and this is one aspect of this Alma game that's really been tough in 2020. They have not forced many turnovers. This is week 10. Well, officially for them, week 9. They do not have an interception.
Wow. Nice throw, that last pass by Pickens. That should have been caught. I mean, by Cartwright.
Right.
Should have been caught by Pickens. He just didn't hang on, but he put it right there in the breadbasket. Single back. Rolling to the right is Sutton.
Oh, there's an interception.
And there's a pickoff at the 25, across the 30, and one of the linebackers, I'm looking for the number.
Trey Fusler
with the pickoff. That'll get him off the field.
That's the first interception for the Airedales in 2020. How about that? Trey Fusler must have hurt me.
Just as you were talking about it. Just as you were mentioning this, the first interception of the season, and Fusler has it, and Alma is in business at their own 32-yard line.
Now let's see if they can get something going on this second offensive set.
Empty backfield, two tights. Now man in motion, and it's going to be a quarterback draw. Escaping one tackle and losing yardage back at the 31-yard line. Do you think it was a face mask?
I think there's flags. There's a flag. The side judge threw it about the 30.
Oh, okay.
And so I don't know if it's going to be
still
a 5
looking for the flag.
Or a 15. Yeah. It's the big one.
Well, you saw the head get turned around.
Absolutely. And people on the live stream as well. And so the Airedales have it at the 46. You'll take them any way you can get them in 2020.
There was a little question about it, if there was a call. I never saw the flag. That will mark it at the 46 of Alma. Single back in the backfield. That's Cronister. And he'll get the handoff, and he's got some room. Cutting across the midfield, and now the 45, 44, and out of bounds. Another, let's see, it may be right at the first down. I was going to call
it
another first
down. Yeah, it's right at the sticks. It's probably going to be about a half a yard shot. That's the old official, a 9.5-yard game, but officially a 9-yard game, as Leland Barkley would say.
Second and less than a yard for the Airedales. On the snap once again, going to the right side is Cronister, and he's got room. He's got the first down and out of bounds as he sweeps to the right side this time and finally run out at around the 27-yard line. I'm sorry, 37-yard line.
Nice 8-yard gain. So back-to-back runs of 8 or 9 and 8 yards for Logan Cronister. And he came into the ballgame with 865 for the year, so he's inching up closer to 1,000.
Running the ball well those last two carries. Now he's going to get it this time. Bounces to the left side. Gets to the 35, down to the 34-yard line. 6:38 still to play here in the opening period. No score. Farmington and Alma, we've had one turnover. On the night, that was an interception by Fusler. Just a moment ago, as Farmington was driving. Receiver split to both sides. Now H-back in motion, and we've got a flag.
We got a penalty on somebody.
Far side. Ball start on Allman. That'll back him up 5 yards. So it'll be a second down and 15 coming up. I'm sorry, not second down and 15. It'll be a second down and 14. 13. Marks it right on the 40-yard line. They need to get to the 27 for the first. Allen with a deep pass left side, and he was looking for Stacy Connor. Overthrows him.
Yeah, he's a little bit, seems a little bit, I'd say a little bit tight, a little too much air under that one. Connor Stacy is going to be your go-to receiver. He comes into the ball game leading the team in yards per reception, 249 yards, 17 catches, and a couple of touchdowns.
Gallister showing a lot of arm, too much arm on that one. Here comes a man in motion, waiting for the snap. And there's a flag, and they got Farmington to jump this time. They got that 5 yards back.
Going to make it a little more manageable, yeah. And, you know.
Well, they were back where they were just before the down, you know.
This might be two-down territory. It's hard to say early in the ball game like this.
McAllister, man in motion. Making some adjustments. Takes a handoff, rolling right. Man out in the flat, caught wide open at the 30. First down, 25, and out of bounds. Near the 20-yard line is Brayden Allen.
Yep, that's Brayden Allen. That's your second leading receiver, and a heck of a game, right? A heck of a game right there, down to the 22, 13-yard reception.
Yeah. Marks it at the 22-yard line, and a first and 10 for the Airedales. On the move. Stops the clock at 5:43 to play in the first quarter. No score. But Alma, they took this over at their own 22, and they have now moved it into the red zone. As on the handoff, here is Cronister again, pushing the pile back to the 15, 14-yard line.
Logan Cronister, kind of an interesting story. How many carries did he have as a running back in 2019? None.
None.
He just kind of came out of nowhere, and he's got the single-game school record for yards rushing. That's crazy.
Wow. And what was that?
How much? 281.
Oh, wow. Monsters game. Cronister again on the handoff. He's got room. Cuts it at the 10. Inside the 10, down to about the 7-yard line. And it is going to be close to a first and goal for the Airedales.
Yep, got a flag.
Oh, let's see what that's about.
Yep.
How are you seeing the flags and I'm not seeing the flags? Where are the flags?
We got a flag back at the 18. This is probably holding.
Ah, there I see it. Now I see it.
Yep, that's going to be holding, so that's going to back it up. Yeah.
Doggone it. Moving it all the way back to the 28-yard line. No first and goal. They still need to get to about the 12 for the first. Wipes out what would have been a first and goal at the 7. And another nice run by Cronister. Twin receivers to the right, tight ends to the right side. Caught out in the left side with a quick toss across the 20 down to the 15-yard line is Connor Stacy.
Boy, some nice yak yards after catch for Connor Stacy, and he gets the ball inside the right at the 15. So a nice pickup of 13 yards on that pass play, making a very manageable third down.
4:21 remaining still in the first quarter. No score. Alma trying to keep this drive going. It's a third down, and here comes a flag. I did see that one.
They have
illegal substitution on Alma.
Wow.
Too many men?
I didn't see that.
Somebody didn't get off the field in time?
I guess not.
Backs them up. They now they need about 8 for that first down. It's third down. quarterback keeper. Now this is up Stacey. The middle. This is Stacy, yeah. the keeper. They were running out of the, I don't know if you'd call that the Wildcats, since he's not a running back, but that's what it was.
And that's a first down. How about that?
Got just inside the first down yard. Just they're going to mark him just shy of the 11. First and 10, Alma.
Stacy with the 9-yard run. And the Airedales are knocking on the door. 3:45 left here in the first quarter.
There you go. So McAllister's back in at quarterback. Hand off. This is Cronister at the 10. Pushes forward close to the 5. And he'll bring up a second down. They can actually get a first to goal at the 1. They will mark this one at the 6-yard line. So it's second down and 5. Single back. That's Cronister back with McAllister. Cronister with the handoff right up the middle. He keeps the legs churning close to the end zone. No signal yet. He may have gotten the first down if he didn't get into the end zone.
Yep, it's going to be a first and goal at
first
the 1.
First and goal at the 1, yep.
Well, tough running for Logan Cronister already with 36 yards rushing, and the Airedales are knocking on the door.
See, I got an old newspaper guy with me here tonight. Yep. He's used to keeping these stats, and that's what I love. And Cronister, he is in easy for the touchdown, Alma. 2:39 in the first period. Right off of the right guard and almost standing up is Logan Cronister for the touchdown, and Alma on the board first.
Nice job of blocking by the right side of the offensive line. That is touchdown number 8 for the senior Logan Cronister. How about some trickery?
Oh, we just ran a 2-point conversion.
We just did a little 2-point pass.
Oh my gosh! they faked me out. I thought they were still adjusting, but they'd already thrown it into the end zone for the 2-point conversion. 8-0 out of it. What happened there, Kevin?
Well, that's going to be a pass to our resident Los Angeles Dodger fan, York. Joseph York moved here as a 7th grader from California, and he catches the 2-point conversion.
They caught me off guard with that one. I thought they were still adjusting the line, but no, they had snapped it, and York catches the 2-point conversion. 8-0 Alma, 2:38 to play in the first quarter. We are back in 1 minute. Okay, well, we'll keep talking here, Kevin, for just a second for our streaming audience here. Yeah, they caught me off guard, but I'm glad you caught that. I never saw what happened.
That is Joseph York's. That's his first offensive touch of the year. Comes in week 10. How about that?
All right.
Heck of a play.
Yeah.
You know, that's a deal, the swinging gate. They do that. They've done that all year.
It looked like they were going to the offset line. I never saw the ball snap.
Normally they run the ball, or the linemen run back over, and then they kick it. That time they threw it for 2.
How close are we, Mr. Bill? Checking for a radio break here. There's the kick. Okay. Taken at the 12, across the 15, the 30. And there's a loose ball. Ooh. They're still scoring. We have just had the kickoff, and there is a scramble. The ball was knocked loose. It was a live ball, Kevin.
It was.
And I think Farmington may have gotten it back.
Wow.
There was a scramble there for the football, though, and it actually came loose at about the 30-yard line. They scrambled for about 6 yards, finally recovered by Farmington back at the 24.
Cardinals are down. They had that first drive for a couple first downs through the interception. So Alma turns turnover into points.
There's a pitch right side on the carry and nothing there. Alma's defensive front doing a good job. Ian Cartwright has dropped for a loss. And this will be a loss. Let's see. This will be a loss of about 6 yards, 5 yards. Nope. I'm sorry.
Loss of 2 yards.
2 yards.
Yep.
They mark it at the 22. I had one of the officials standing back there at the 18.
That was the two kids right there making that tackle lead the team in tackles. That'd be Landon Burkhardt, number 34, and Jacob Corsi, number 5.
Minute 53 to play in the quarter. Quick toss left side. Can't hang on.
Nope.
That's receiver Tate Pickens. had it in his hands, could not hang on to it.
I believe he heard a few footsteps. So, heck of a start by the defense.
Yes.
Alma's defense came to play, and they've made some plays tonight, and we're getting some subs in there.
Well, Alma's defensively has done well on first and second down. It's third down that's given the problem until they had that interception a while ago. What a drive that turned out to be. Ended up being a 78-yard drive. Back, now tossing, left side, caught. Pickens does hold on to this one at the 38-yard line. Over on the right side is Tate Sutton, who hooks up with Pickens.
Here's another one. So that's a big, big play all the way up to the 42.
Yep.
20-yard pass play.
I mean, Farmington has gotten out of third and longs.
That is
a few times.
That's three third down conversions, three out of four that they've had in this ballgame.
Not to make light of that one that they didn't. That was an interception. Sutton, empty backfield, trips to the right, fakes, now he's going to keep up the middle, and he'll be stacked up at the 41-yard line. This will be a loss.
They have not been able to run the ball. They have run the ball for not many yards.
They're going to... It's probably maybe an inch loss, but they're going to basically mark him back at the line of scrimmage. It's just shy of the line of scrimmage, just shy of the 42.
They've really just had one long run at the quarterback draw earlier for 12 yards.
Sutton with a handoff to Cartwright, trying that left side, and he is stacked up after a couple of yards. Close to the 45-yard line. Another third down and long coming up.
Farmington's got them right where they want them.
Third down and seven.
Let's see if the defense can get off the field again here.
Yeah. 40 seconds as the clock winds down for the first quarter. They'll probably get one more playoff, I would think.
I would definitely watch again for the quarterback draw.
Here's the pitch over on the left side. This is Cartwright. He's got room. He's got the first down again as we're down to 15 seconds remaining in the quarter. Cartwright picking up the first down on a third down and seven. Once again, they convert.
Well, they saw an unbalanced line, and I think that was probably an audible. And, boy, he had a lot of running room. He runs for a big chunk of yards. He runs for 12 yards and a first down.
Bring up, that's the end of the quarter. That's the end of the first period. Alma leading 8-0 after a 78-yard drive following an interception. Alma leading Farmington. We are back in 1 minute.
As we take a moment to honor members of our Alma High School chapter of the Future Farmers of America, the students recently won in their exhibition category at the Crawford County and or Arkansas State Fair. Jonathan Still, Emma Boyd, Heidi Higgins, Haley Higgins, Taylor Jones, Lane Broyles, and Stephen Brister. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it from these outstanding young men and women. Ladies and gentlemen, you also still have time to get your 50-50 raffle tickets for Project Graduation. They are under the stands on the home side. All proceeds benefit Project Graduation 2021.
Alma to start the second period. 8-0. Alma leading Farmington. Handoff. This is Cartwright. He's got some room. Crosses the 40. 39-yard line. Just off tackle. And picks up a couple of yards. One of the better first down plays for Farmington on the night, but back-to-back pretty good runs for Cartwright.
Yep. He ran for 4 yards. He got a really bad spot. I thought he was a little bit further down. They're going to mark it at the 39.
Eye formation, single receivers to each side. Sutton with the handoff. Cartwright bounces out and escapes one tackler. He gets just beyond the line of scrimmage. Bring up another third down and five coming up.
He ran about 12 yards for a yard.
Yep.
That's all he got.
Well, he bounced out of there. It looked like he was going to turn it into something, and then, again, it only ended up being a yard. He looked like he had daylight for just a moment. So they'll mark him at the 38-yard line. 11 minutes to play in the first half. Still 8-0 Alma. High formation again. The old favorite. Here's Cartwright right up the middle. Right up the gut. Gets to the 35-yard line. Now we got a fourth down. What do you do here?
Well, it's the first time, second time they haven't converted on third down, but definitely will go for it, I would assume. Leave the offense. This is kind of no man's land.
Yeah, it is.
Too far in, not back far enough.
That's right. That's exactly right. That is exactly right. Single back with Sutton in the backfield. That's Cartwright. Sutton back. Looking now, he's going to spin, rolls to the left side. Ducks under one tackle. Spins at the 40. Now
oh,
tries
man.
To try. Tosses a quick one to Pickens. He gets close and does get the first down.
Wow.
Across the 30-yard line to the 29-yard line. And that was some... He improvised there.
He was spinning and turning and moving and spinning, and they have a first down at the 29.
Well, at the last
crazy.
Moment, you had to be sure he wasn't going to cross the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
But he did get it thrown behind the line of scrimmage in the first down. Pickens hung on to that one. He found him. Quick toss to him. Improvision. First and 10 from the 29-yard line of Alma. Hand off Cartwright. He's got some room. Breaking tackles down to the 10, 20-yard line, close to another first down.
Yeah, that's a nice gain on first down of 9 yards. And he has had a pretty good ball game. This, you know, we're under 10 minutes left in the first half, and we've had each team only two series. I mean, there's been a lot of controlled offense.
Ball squarely on the 20. 8-0 Alma with 9:08 to play. Here in the first half.
He might be changing the play here.
Offset eye. They have an H-back. Handoff, Cartwright. Left side. Escapes one tackle inside the 10. They are starting to get some good rushing yardage now.
Yeah, they're starting to get a push on the offensive line. And they weren't really running for much early, but that's a back-to-back big, big runs. First and goal for Farmington. Put that ball down at the 8. That's a 12-yard run for Mr. Cartwright.
First and goal, Farmington for the Cardinals. High formation again. Mike Adams going back to his old standard formation here. They were doing empty backfields, single back. Now they've gone to the I formation and having some success. Hand off gets about maybe a yard, maybe. Bring up second and goal.
He might have lost a yard.
Ah, you're
one.
Right.
Yeah.
They've marked him back. No, it looks like he's right back where he was, still at the 9.
Big, big defensive series for the Airedales.
Absolutely.
Trying to get off the field again, get the offense back out there.
Sutton, offset eye. Short draw, toss to the end zone, looking for Pickens. Overthrows him, incomplete, third and goal.
Yeah, the closest man there was Travis Biggs. That'd be your assistant Alma superintendent.
Okay.
And if he uses two hands, he catches it. He didn't catch it. So,
big down coming up here, third and goal from the 9-yard line for the Cardinals.
Pickens is a really big target. The kid is, he's got a little bit of size out there. Donovan, 6'3".
All the receivers are all stacked to the left side. Now here comes a man in motion. Fakes the handoff, spins the left side, escapes.
Oh!
He falls at the 15.
Falls out.
Sutton falls at the 15. Is it going to be ruled a fumble?
It's going to be a
the
sack.
The ball was out, wasn't
yep.
down.
So it's going to be a sack and a stop back at the 13, loss of 4.
That brings up fourth and goal.
Fourth and goal, they're going to bring on the kicking unit, it looks like.
One area that Alma's had good luck in this year is teams missing field goals. Let's see if that trend continues here. Opponents missing field goals.
This is Luis Zabala.
He got it.
And he did get the field goal. This was 34 yards? 30 yards. Right 30, 30 yards yep. is what they got. 30-yard field goal by Zabala is good. And so Farmington on the board. 8-3, 7:09 to play in the first quarter. We're back in 1 minute. This is our first. Now, Kevin goes to all the games, but this is the first one you've actually worked. Well, you've written.
Yeah, oh yeah. Well, I'm doing all the games for Chip.
Nice drive for Farmington as we are back. Results in a 30-yard field goal by Zabala. There is a kick taken at the 3 across the 10, 15, the 20 to the 23.
Kevin Mills on the return.
24-yard line. That is Kevin Mills on the return for the Airedales.
Nice return. Let's see if the Airedales can have a response, if they can answer to the Cardinals field goal drive there, scoring drive.
All right, so Kevin, here you go. Where would you rather go? You've done a lot of high school sports from corner to corner in this state.
Mm-hmm.
What would be the best trip? Going to Batesville? Going to Little Rock? Going to Hot Springs Lakeside or going to Texarkana?
Well, I tell you.
Which one would you like?
Probably Batesville. I mean, they're all tough.
I would think Hot Springs. Here's a handoff on a sweep. Left side, this is going to be lost yardage for Cronister.
Yep.
As he is slung down, as the Farmington Cardinals got penetration and were able to catch him in the backfield, sling him down for the loss at the 20.
They've done that play twice where they kind of ran him in motion and just trying to get him outside, and it just has not worked.
Second down and 14.
More success going up the
just
gut.
Just going right up the back. Yeah. Right off tackle, right off guard, yeah. Empty backfield. McAllister with a quick slant toss, caught at the 28. Got some of that yardage back. And picked up some.
Yep, Nehemiah Relliford in my sixth period class.
Ah, there you go.
Yeah, there you go. And 9-yard reception. So he had his first ever touchdown of any kind last week in the game against Greenbrier. How about that?
All right. What do you teach here at Alma?
We do online learning. And so kids can make up credit so they can take stuff.
There you go.
Yep.
But you actually, even though it's online learning, you have some in class.
Yeah, absolutely.
McAllister back, looking, tosses left side, too high, looking for Connor, who Stacy Connor, who was open. He just threw it too
high. Yeah, that's a tough break there. That first play got him. That loss of 4 yards to Cronister, and Alma goes 3 and out. So Alma's had 2 drives, both 2 3 and outs, and 1 12-play methodical 68-yard scoring drive. So really kind of interesting. This is going to be a huge defensive stand.
It's a wobbly kick. See if it gets an Alma. No, it does not get an Alma. Well, yeah, now it does. Cross midfield, 49, 48-yard line where it rolls out of bounds. So he's been able to get the rolls a couple of times.
Well, that's not the that's a 23-yard punt. That's not the punt you wanted. Good field position for Farmington. They've got some momentum after that field goal drive. This is a big series because, remember, they won the toss and elected to defer, so they'll get the ball to start the second half.
Again, Mike Adams going right back with that I formation. That has been working, having that lead fullback, and here they go again. This time a new running back as they go off tackle. This appears to be Kane Taylor, a junior. Am I reading that right? 25?
Yeah, that's 25 on the carry for 3 yards. Gets him across midfield.
So No pickup of 3, 2nd and 7 coming up. 8-3, Alma leading Farmington, but good field position for the Cardinals, as Kevin had mentioned. High formation again. I think he sees something with this formation that he really likes, and this is right up the middle, and some more running room across the 40 down to the 39 once again is Kane Taylor.
Yeah, that's a gain of 10. So a first down and momentum, so the defense with under 5 minutes left here in this first half really needs to get a couple stops. And once again, another ball game where the other team, the opponent's converting some big third downs as well.
Well, those Taylors know how to run the ball.
They do, don't they?
Here's a toss, Taylor, left side on the sweep. And he gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it. Alma doing a good job of stringing that play out. Not to to make the stop was Jonathan.
Jonathan Polito.
Polito.
Nice tackle. Good two-handed tackle. That's a really good open field tackle.
Well, he did a good job stringing it out there, mm-hmm. as well. 39-yard line and second down and 10 coming up. No gain on that play.
Got him an old school play under center.
Oh,
and
down. It's down. He slipped it. Actually, hit the knee, went down and touched. That was Nate Sutton that dropped back. And as he dropped the tackle, knee touched, and that'll be ruled a sack at the 45.
And big Nathan Whalen, 6'7", 215-pound senior, a basketball player as well.
If he's 6'7", he's got to be playing basketball. McAllister needs to be. I hope he's playing basketball, too.
He is. That is big Nate's seventh sack on the season. So there you go.
3:19. Here's a quick toss on the right side. Caught. I think this is Pickens, I think. Across the 40, down to the 35, 34-yard line. Let's see who this is. Is it Pickens?
Yep. Yes. Wow. So another big fourth down play coming up for the Cardinals. 12 yards on that reception.
Boy, this quarter is going by in a hurry. We're going to be out of the first half in a moment.
Yeah.
Under 3 minutes now to play in the first half. You can tell the teams are running the ball at 8 o'clock. Single backfield, but under center. And now they're going with the end around. Here comes Pickin coming the other way on the reverse. He's at the 35.
Oh,
off
nice
his
tackle.
Feet at the 33. Yes, open one-on-one tackle there at the 33-yard line. Was that Kyle Jones?
That was Kyle Jones, and the tackle was made by Jacob Corson. Boy, he is Mr. Consistent. He has had an outstanding senior season. So a big stop by the Airedales, who get it with 2.5 left here at the first half. And, Marty, a chance to maybe tack on some points.
Absolutely. Again, they gave up some good field position a moment ago. They only had half the field to work with, Farmington. And I'm able to get them out in just a couple of series. So, and enough time to work with here. Let's see what happens. McAllister gets the snap. Quick toss over to Connor Stacy. Short gain across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Second and 7 coming up for the Airedales.
Just
continues to run.
Yeah, just got to get positive carries, positive chance to keep the chains moving. Give your kicker, Dane Martin, a chance. He's got a nice leg.
Single back. Hand off. This is Cronister. Up the middle, he gets across to the 38-yard line, knocked off of his feet.
Nice response by the Cardinals. That looked like that play may go for a bigger run. Somebody's down on the field.
Still have an Airedale down. This may be Cronister. Can you tell?
I can't tell.
I think it's Cronister. See if I can get my field glasses on. They're still working on it. Let's see if I can pick him up.
Yep, that's Cronister.
Yeah, he's hobbling off on one leg. That is not good news for Alma.
No. He had had an ankle injury about 3 weeks ago, and I don't know if he kind of re-aggravated that or not, but that's a 3-yard run. And for now, he is on the sideline. Let's see if the Airedales can pick up a third down and about four.
All right.
And play resumes at third down and five.
See who the new back's going to be. McAllister stays in as quarterback. There's no
empty
back.
Set, yep.
Going to go empty backfield. Trips to the right. McAllister back over the middle. Caught at midfield. 40. Down to the 35. The 30. The 25, and inside the 20-yard line, I believe this is Connor Stacy.
Nope, that's going to be number five. That's
five.
Jacob Corsi.
Okay,
yeah, Corsi. Corsi. When you need a play, that kid always seems to make plays for you.
Off to the races with
yep.
Corsi, and they will rule him at the 19-yard line. And still a lot of time for the Airedales here. With a minute 29 still on the clock, he got out of bounds, stopped the clock. And they're going to take a timeout.
That is a 42-yard pass play to Jacob Corsi, who came in to the game with 12 receptions, couple touchdowns, had one long TD pass of 53 yards, and you thought for a minute he might surpass that 53-yard catch and score. But the Airedales are inside the 20 with a minute 29.
Alma going to they're taking a timeout, and we may have talked too long here with. To get into the break, we'll try to make that up here in just a moment. But the Airedales set up. They had taken over after stopping Farmington on downs. And that big, long pass play to Jacob Corsi over the middle and then running for it.
Well, the same player who made the play on the fourth down tackle, Jacob Corsi, just made that long reception on third down in about five and a half. So a huge first down, huge conversion for the Airedales, who have it inside the 20. And with the minute 29 left, two timeouts left for Coach Rusty Bush, a chance to extend that lead a little bit.
Coming out of the timeout, McAllister. Man in motion, he'll keep it right up the middle on the quarterback draw as he gets to the
number three, Connor Stacy.
That's going to be Connor Stacy. That's another Wildcat.
Oh, and they're out of the Wildcat again. I'm sorry.
So Connor Stacy, number three, taking that snap and just running straight ahead. They had a tight set. They had big Nate Whalen was in it tight end, and the Noise kid, the young sophomore, was in the ball game. Brady, Noise.
I'm checking it this time for sure. It's McAllister at quarterback this time. Twin receivers each side. Over the middle, caught, 5-yard line, inside the five, and this is Connor Stacy.
Yeah, that's Stacy.
That's enough. We're now there now.
Stacy with the catch. And down at the 3-yard line, it'll be first and goal, but there's under a minute, and the clock's running at 47 seconds.
And so you don't have your star running back in there, so I think that's going to be probably Jacob Corsi.
Trips
probably
to the right,
to
rolling
block.
To the right, throwing to the end zone,
oh,
intercepted!
No.
In the end zone, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, midfield, 45, 40, 35, down to the 32-yard line. And this is Elliot Thompson, I think, or
well,
Jacob Jalen.
Yep, you know, he'll watch
Elliot
the film.
Elliot Thompson is with the interception.
He'll watch the film, and what he's going to see is that there were a lot of white jerseys on that side of the field. Wow.
Threw it right to him in the end zone, picked it off, and almost took it to the house.
He did. And now with 24 seconds, they're set
now
up.
Now Farmington's got a chance.
Yeah.
Back is Cartwright. Rolling to the right, he's got time, tosses over the middle, caught at the 22, down to the 20-yard line.
State Sutton's pass is complete to number 22, Elliot Thompson.
And on the reception, the same guy that made the interception a moment ago, Elliot Thompson.
Wow.
That's enough for a Farmington first.
So they're going to burn a timeout.
Yeah.
And
15 seconds.
Yeah, they're going to have one left.
All right, we'll take a break.
Wow.
15 seconds, 8-3, Alma leading Farmington, back in 1 minute. We are back. 15 seconds still to play in the half in Farmington. After that, both sides have had a turnover. Now Farmington, when Alma picked him off, the Fusler in the first quarter, that led to an Alma score.
Yeah.
See, Farmington is going to return the favor.
Well, that was a huge play.
Back is Sutton. Toss over the middle. Pickens is who he was looking for. Couldn't hang on. And there's still 11 seconds. Not sure if this is in Zavala's range or not. He had a 30-yard field goal earlier.
He's right. Would look from here be about 37, 38
yeah.
maybe.
Yep. Farmington still has one timeout left. They're going to go back out of the I formation. Sutton back, looking. He's going to toss to the end zone, and this one, it was a jump ball, 50-50. And he was looking for Pickens again, who had it in his hands.
Yeah.
Pickens has dropped a few.
He had a chance.
Yep.
So now what do you do? You got 6 seconds. You got time maybe for one more play. They're going to bring in the kicker in.
Yeah, Zavala is going to come on. This is going to be about a 37-yard attempt.
The 38 yeah.
yards. Luis Zavala, a junior kicker, also plays wide receiver. And a timeout. Going to use their final timeout here. We'll take it with them. 8-3. Alma leads it over Farmington, but we've only got 6 seconds remaining in the half. We'll be right back. No, 38 yards. They are at 38. 38-yard attempt from Zavala.
Kind of interesting that they would call a timeout for their own kicker. And you know what?
Now Alma's going to do it. Yeah. Well. Let him think about it some more. Not a bad move. We'll take another break ourselves with 6 seconds remaining. 8-3, Alma leading back in 1 minute. Timeout. They still show it with two, but I think that's not right. I think they only have one more left, but they could call another one. Let's see if they do.
Mercy.
Yeah,
they're going to call again.
You can't carry these over. So let him think about it. They're going to use another timeout. 6 seconds. We'll take the break. 8-3. Alma leading Farmington. Back in just a moment. Let's see if the Alma coaches are thinking the same way. Let him think. I mean, again, you might as well.
He's had a lot of time to think about it. Yeah.
You're right. Let's see if they use the last timeout here. Let's see. Oh, there was some movement.
It's either going to be encroachment or against Farmington.
Yeah, no, it's against Farmington. Yep. They're going to back them up. There's going to be a longer field goal. So the timeouts may be starting to work a little bit. The offensive linemen are also thinking about it as well as the kicker. So this is going to back it now to the 26, making it a 43-yard field goal attempt. So if they use that last time out here. Nope. Yep, there's the hold, the kick, on the way, and it is blocked. Rolls into the end zone. The strategy paid off. There's still 1 second remaining on the clock.
Well, with 1 second, they get to take a kneel down if they want to. But, man, dadgummit, you go back to that interception that Hunter McAllister had. Just a tough, tough, tough play. You have a chance to go up maybe 15-16-3, if not, at least 11-3. So a huge play for Farmington and a nice defensive stand late by the Airedales.
Getting them to, you know, get the movement, get that extra 5 yards was huge.
It looked like the snap was a little bit low, and it looked like the holder had a little bit, he kind of bobbled it some.
And take a knee. That's the end of the first half. But the score, Alma 8, Farmington 3. We are at the half. We've got more with Kevin Taylor. I bet he's got a few stats for us that we'll pass along. And stay with us. We'll be right back. Take a couple of minutes here, Mr. Bill. Kevin and I will talk. Kevin says that out of his trips for Alma, his best trips would be Batesville. I say Hot Springs. Hey, man, how are you, sir? Okay. It's going to be a drive. Kevin's writing down some stats here. Mr. Bill, they're acting like this election's over. We'll see. I don't think it is. I think it's going to keep going and going. I was getting notifications while ago that we're going to do some live shots here in our Prime program tonight for some kind of speech, so we'll see. Okay. All right, we are back. Marty Houston, Kevin Taylor here at the half. 8-3, Alma leading Farmington. Kevin, you got some stats for us.
I do. They're pretty even, and of course, two turnovers were gigantic. The Farmington turnover led to an Alma touchdown, and the Alma turnover took away a potential Alma touchdown. So the Airedales, 23 offensive plays for 133 yards in the first half, and for the Cardinals, 33 offensive snaps, 123 yards. Logan Cronister, we're being told, is done. 9 carries, 35 yards. If he doesn't play it again, he'll finish his career in this year with 900 yards rushing and 8 touchdowns. That's
so
a tough, tough.
You're saying done, maybe not even playing next week.
Well, I don't. He's maybe done for tonight. I can't say about next week, but that's tough. That's tough. You know, the first half, Hunter McAllister really had a good first half. 6 out of 10, the one interception, 93 yards passing. Connor Stacey has 3 catches to lead the team with 29 yards. Jacob Corsi had the 1 for 42. And, you know, I thought it was a good spirited effort in the first half defensively for the Airedales, no doubt.
Well, again, both teams had success on the ground. I think that kept the clock moving for both sides in the first half.
Yeah.
Mike Adams has found something running out of the I formation, and he's stayed with that. Let's see if he does that more in the second half. Alma making adjustments without Cronister, though, without having his legs in the second half. We really when you looked at the time he went out, there was a big pass play. They really did not have the chance to see who was going to be in for Cronister at running back, but seeing who fills in for him and what kind of success they may continue to have on the ground will be a big story for Alma in the second half.
Well, there's two kids that are potential running backs to come in and help, Devin Poole. Devin is a junior running back. He also plays a lot of defense. He's a really good football player. And they have a young sophomore named Reagan Birchfield, who's had a great, great year defensively, number 23. And so he's got a chance to come back and play well at running back. But who knows? But the thing about it, you get down to the three-yard line, and that's Logan Cronister country. That's where he's going to take it in.
Yeah.
And you're going to be up, 16 to 3, and that's just – That's a tough break.
I love these sophomores.
Yeah.
You love these sophomores because a lot of times you throw them in those situations, they don't know any better, and, there they go. Birchfield may be a guy to watch for coming up here in the second half for the Airedales. 8-3 Alma leading Farmington. It was a 78-yard touchdown drive for Alma following an interception, and they were able to take it in on a Cronister touchdown run from 1 yard out. And then the two-point conversion on the swinging gate.
Yep. I mean, Joseph York, I guess, could probably maybe play some running back as well. But really just a tough break. And that injury kind of defines 2020 for Alma football. But again, with everything that's happened in this year in the world and coronavirus and COVID, to be playing on week 10 in November, I think, is awesome.
All right, we're at the half with Alma leading Farmington 8-3. We are going to take another quick break as the Alma band here for the final home game of the regular season tonight. We'll take the break. We'll have more with Kevin and myself on the Houston return after this. Let's keep them rolling. Talk to our live stream audience while this is going. Glad to have you folks watching on the live stream. Pardon? Oh, 2 minutes? 2 minutes. Two, yes. Yes. Kevin, you got any more stats to share? Or is that it? Okay. Yep. I like it. I always like it. Kevin, you're a big Houston Astros fan.
Oh, yeah.
And this is for our folks that are watching tonight, maybe baseball fans out there.
You bet.
Astros are on the water flag.
Probably did worse things.
Here's the thing. We still have not heard anything about Justin Turner breaking COVID.
Join along as the Pride of Alma plays the Alma Fight Song. Let's give it one more time for the Pratt Alma Marching Band. As the band exits the field, they want to say a special thank you to the Alma Band Boosters for picking the band during this evening's game. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to take a moment to stop to thank our team sponsors for the football team. It takes a lot to keep a football team going throughout the season, and we couldn't do it without these folks. Team sponsors for this year are Elite Roofing, The Current Church, Donald Smith, Kipper Baptist Church, and CV's Family Foods. Feed an entire football team for a season, and it took a lot of volunteer team meal coordinators. At this time, we'd like to thank those folks. Big thank you goes out to Heather Greenwood, Brandy Langley, Angela Cole, and Becca Corsi. Thank you folks for taking care of our volunteer team meals. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'd also like to stop and thank our stadium fireworks sponsors for the football season. Stadium fireworks sponsors are Brian and Dusty Smith, Doug and Ken Lockridge, Sonic of Alma, Shannon and Angela Cole, Harvest Bank of Alma, Ken's Insulation, and tonight's sponsor, Jim Grizzle Tire Company of Fort Smith. Thank you again to all the sponsors who took care of our fireworks this football season. You a 50-50 raffle ticket for Project Graduation. We will draw that winner at the end of the third quarter and announce the winner. You want a ticket with a winning number, you've got to come buy yourself a 50-50 raffle ticket under the home stands across from the concession stand. Get you a ticket, be a winner. Thank you.
the Airedale. Number 87.
Oh, Alma will kick off to get...
Ian Cartwright on return, tackled by number 15, Jonathan Polito. Cardinals will start their drive, first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Tackled by number 37, Ramos, and number 15, Jonathan Polito. Cam 6 on the play, brings up 2nd down.
He's getting the blocking out of that leap. That is bread and butter offense, but he is going to that and finding success out of this I formation. Here comes Cartwright again, up the middle.
Almas had 7 defensive turnovers on the year. That's not very many. And, boy, number 8 would be a good one right here, wouldn't it?
Interception from each side tonight. This is going to be 3rd and short. 3rd down coming up for Farmington, but it's 3rd and 2 coming up.
Big, 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 big play for the defense.
From the 27-yard line.
He's under center.
Need to get just beyond the 29. Single back, and this is some big room this time again for Cartwright across the 30. He's got the first down at the 31.
Well, just got enough of a crease to get 4 yards. So
just off that right tackle.
Carries of 6, 2, and 4 to start this third quarter drive.
Up to the 31-yard line. Just underway for the second half. 8-3. Alma leading Farmington. Single backfield. Slashes to the left side. The handoff this time going to Kane Taylor. He'll pick up decent yardage across 35 to 36.
He got a really good spot as well on that play.
He was like, "Wow, these narrows, these numbers are narrow." I'm like, "There's no way." But it does look like
it does.
Numbers because
does.
Of the way he's got it pulled up there in the back. There you can see him right there. It looks like, but if you pulled down that shirt, it would be there. You could see the bottom part of it, and it is number 4. The handoff, we were calling it the pick, and our apologies. On right side.
Now here's another big play on third down.
Another third down coming up for Farmington. They've had success on that third down tonight. All on the ground so far.
This is a big, big series because now you're down to series. And, you're in the second half, and it's a tight ball game, one possession game.
Dual receivers to the left. Receiver and tight end to the right side. Quick toss is batted back.
How about
incomplete.
That?
Incomplete, yeah.
Big Nate got his paw, I think, got his hand up there and knocked that one away.
Knocked down at the line of scrimmage, and that'll bring up 4th down.
They're going to punt it, or it does appear. So that's a huge, huge play for the Alma defense.
Dropping back for Alma, Jacob Corsi. And let's see who else is dropping back here. Also, Trey Fusler. We had our interception earlier. It was Trey Fuson.
Right? It was. And if you're curious, I also did coach Jacob in little baseball too.
I was just crossing my mind. He coached him in baseball too. A fair catch called for at the 31-yard line and made by Corsi. And that's where Alma will take over first and 10.
Well, that's a nice play. Nice stop by the defense. Big play by Nathan Whalen, who got his big mitt up there to swat that ball down across the middle. Incomplete pass. So Alma takes over. Not bad field position or 32.
Yeah, they actually gave him a decent spot there,
yep.
where the fair catch. I thought it was a 31. They actually moved it up just a hair, shy of 32.
Now let's see who's in your backfield. Is that Brady Noyes or is that Reagan Birchfield? I can't tell.
And McAllister is back there at quarterback. Let's see.
It's Brady Noyes. Yeah.
And here's a toss over. Oh! It was into traffic, but caught
at
the 38-yard line.
Golly. Connor Stacy's played a lot of basketball in his life, and he went up for a big rebound right there.
He had to go between two Farmington Cardinals and pull that one down at the 39-yard line, but a nice catch by Connor Stacy there. And that's a pickup of about 7 yards. So
that's a huge play on first down.
I thought for a moment it was going to get picked.
I did too.
It was right there in the crowd. Nobody in the backfield. Empty backfield, twin receivers to both sides. McAllister back, looking, tosses to the right side, caught. This is Stacy, and he drops, and now there's a flag coming out late.
This is going to be, this could be helmet to helmet. Let's see what the flag's going to be on. He had it and dropped it. He also lost part of his shoulder pads, or his jersey there.
I got that straight now. Let's see what the call is.
Interesting.
It looked like the flag came out after the catch was made.
Yeah, it looked like he had it and then dropped it. It's going to be against the Cardinals.
Yeah, personal foul.
Yep.
Yeah. Personal foul called, and that is going to be a big first down for Alma. That will move it all the way into Farmington territory at the 46-yard line.
Well, that's a penalty. You know, the old-timers back in the day are saying, oh, gosh, well, I don't play football. But, boy, and you know, so much technology and all these trainers and all these specialty, you know, got to take care of kids.
Yeah. Empty backfield again for McAllister. Twin receivers to each side. And we've got flags just as the it's going to be a dead ball foul.
Yep. I did not see the false start.
Yeah, that's what it is. It'll back them to their own 49. So back into Alma territory now. First down and 15 for the Airedales. 8:09, third quarter. Alma continues to lead 8-3.
Noy is going to check back in, and
he's the single running back.
Of course, he's going to check out.
Takes a handoff, rolling to the right. The throw to the right, caught just in bounds with the reception is Briley White.
Briley White at the 40. He had a touchdown in last week's ball game, and that's a huge play on the first down play, and
absolutely.
Now you're manageable.
You're out of the long yardage situation.
Yeah.
Now you got second and five, which is, again, like you say, much more manageable. McAllister with the keeper up the middle on the draw. He gets to the 37-yard line.
He should have it. Yep.
Pretty close.
First down.
Yep. Right at the marker. 39-yard line, first and 10, Alma.
Hunter's got those big legs, big strides. And, boy, that's hard to stop when you get those guys going. Briley White came into this ball game on the season with just a couple of receptions. That's a big one.
McAllister. Back, toss over the middle. He's got a man. Out of the hands of Relaford, Nehemiah Relaford. 5'5" senior. He had it in his hands. It was actually a nicely thrown ball by McAllister, and he just could not hang on at the 5-yard line. That was a touchdown.
Boy, that's a tough one.
Stops the clock at 7:34 with the incomplete pass. I mean, it was right there in his mitts at the 5. Here's the quarterback draw for McAllister at the 35 down to the 33-yard line.
He takes a pretty good pop at the 33. So now you've got third down and about 7. And I guess as far as the running game goes, this is kind of where you're at.
Yep.
I mean, is this what you're going to do? You're just going to let your quarterback kind of scramble around? They're going to call
timeout. Yeah. Timeout, Alma. 7:05 to play third quarter. We'll take it with them. 8-3. The Airedales lead it. Big third down coming up. We'll be back with that in a moment. Franks. We're going to mention John Franks on the live stream because he's watching. On the third down, it's going to bring up fourth down. He only got about one on that. They're at the 32-yard line is where they'll mark it. And they're going to go for it here, Kevin.
Yeah, fourth down and fourth and a bunch. Let's see if they can convert this.
H-back in motion. Offset eye. We're going to see if they can get Farmington to jump.
Did Alma call timeout again? Nope.
Yeah, false start. They're going to back him up five. Now, what do you do here?
Well,
would you still go for it?
No, I would punt. I would. Yeah. I would kind of pooch punt it and let your defense make a play.
Yeah.
And we'll see. We'll see.
See if Dane Martin comes in.
Yeah. Well, McAllister last week.
I don't see Martin coming in.
Last week he pooch punted a couple of times.
Okay.
Let's see what they do.
Empty backfield. Yeah. It would be set up for that. Trips to the left. Let's see what's going on here. Nope, they're going for it. He's tossing over the middle. He's got a man, but he way overthrew everyone.
Somebody was on the wrong page, ran the wrong route.
Oh, yeah, big time. He actually had him in the seam open and overthrew it and incomplete, and so Alma will give it up on downs.
Well, it's a tough break. So now they take over in really pretty good shape as well at the 37.
Stops the clock at 6:09 to play in the third quarter. 8-3 still. Alma leads it. Airedale scored on their second possession on a nice drive, running the ball. Here's a quick toss right side, and we will get the guy right this time. This is Devontae Donovan with the catch.
That is.
He gets out to the 40-yard line. See the way he's got that jersey? But those of you watching on the live stream, you can see how he's got the jersey pulled up there. You cannot tell that's a 4. Just looks like the upper part of the 4, which looks like 11 to me.
Well, it's our first time to see Farmington in 2020, so it does indeed look.
Yeah, he's got that jersey pulled up. It was confusing to me, and that's not hard to do. There's a a delayed handoff and nothing going for Cartwright as he got a yard, and that was it to the 41-yard line, 39-yard.
He actually lost a yard, so yeah. Nice play by Devin Poole, who is a junior. Made a big play, big third down for Alma defense.
Farmington's had success on third down. Let's see what happens here. Sutton rolling to the right with the throw. Caught. First down again at the Alma 45, 44-yard line. And that was Donovan again with the reception.
Wow.
Again, the third and long Farmington has had success all night with that.
That's a huge 18-yard pass play on third down and 8.
Yeah.
Wow.
They're going to mark it at the 43-yard line. Back to the power eye. Sutton under center. Receiver split to each side. Short drop. Slant toss over the middle, caught at the 32-yard line and brought down. And this time, boy, who is that? Is that Colin Hummel? I think that's Hummel with the reception.
It's back-to-back nice throws by the quarterback. They're kind of lulling them to sleep. They kind of stopped the run.
Does that look like a 9?
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. But they got these jerseys on these receivers pulled up. It's probably by design. Short drop again for Sutton. Pulls it down, rolling to the left. Stops, wants to run with it.
He's going to be dropped.
And now there comes a late flag. There may be a helmet-to-helmet on that one.
Well, that's a tough play. Quarterback is dropped back at the 37-38, and I believe they're going to get him.
Yeah. It was after, personal foul.
Oh, face mask.
Face mask. And it's going to be on Alma, and it will give a first down to Farmington.
I didn't see that, but It was right there. He threw it right away. Well, he was right on top of it.
Usually you see those face masks when you're having to chase these guys down, or you're tackling them on the run. This one was not that case. He had already ducked down, and he was on top of him, and somehow got a hold of the face mask while he was down. And that will mark the ball down to the 23-yard line, first and 10 for the Cardinals. 3:56 to play here in the third quarter. Still 8-3 Alma, but Farmington has new life with the penalty. Here's a handoff, Cartwright trying to bounce it to the right side. He's stacked up at the line of scrimmage and driven back. No gain.
That was not a first down, by the way.
Yeah, that was not. You're right.
Yeah.
It's going to be a second down and
very short.
Yeah, I thought that they had the first down. I thought it was automatic with a face mask.
Got it too. But no, that was no gain for Cartwright.
Well, see, so, he was sacked, and so you got to mark it from where he was sacked at. I just thought it carried an automatic first down. So it's second down and one. Offset eye. Hand off straight ahead. This is Taylor. And he looks like he's got the first down as he pushes the pile. Yep. Kane Taylor coming in, and he does move the pile to the 20-yard line. And that's where it will be first and 10 for Farmington.
Three carries for 13 yards back in the first half. He has 2 for 8 here, so he's giving them a nice, some nice depth off the bench. 5 carries in the ball game for 21 yards.
He stays in, Kane Taylor. Dotting the eye. Hand off straight ahead. Just off tackle. He'll drag tacklers for about 3 yards down to the 17.
Reagan Birchfield on the tackle there. Big, big defensive stand for the Airedales here. Let's see if they can hold on to that lead.
Absolutely.
8-3 late in the third quarter.
Yep.
Fast ball game.
Receivers split to both sides again out of the I formation. Short drop. Sutton over the middle. Caught and dropped by Devontae Donovan.
Well, he was
He had the touchdown. He had a slant pattern touchdown over the middle in his hands and dropped it.
He did. He was trying to garner it in and ready to celebrate a TD and just couldn't hang on to it.
Yeah. He's had a couple of those tonight.
Well, Farmington's where they want to be, third down and long.
Thing is, on the other drops, we put those on Pickens. It wasn't Pickens. So Devontae Donovan, that's really his first drop. Back, Sutton throws to the end zone and batted away. Is it intercepted? It is. Picked off in the end zone.
That's unbelievable. Two interceptions tonight, both by Trey Fusler.
Fusler stepped in front of it. I could not tell if he had hung on going to the ground, and he did. So an interception, second pickoff tonight, second of the season.
Well, that's
both by the same guy.
Yeah, that's a big defensive stand. That's only the 8th takeaway that this team has had in 2020.
And they've had 2 interceptions of the season,
both
tonight.
Both of them tonight. Alma
quarterbacks. And that was just as big, you know, throwing to the end zone.
Alma quarterbacks have combined for 15 interceptions.
McAllister back, throws a short dump pass at the 20. 25, this is Jacob Corsi.
Yep, old reliable.
Corsi will get decent yardage to the 28-yard line. Third quarter is just flying by.
It is.
There's not been a lot of clock stoppage. Twin receivers to each side for the Airedales. Empty backfield. McAllister, quick toss over the middle and throws behind the intended receiver, Connor Stacy, and incomplete.
He threw a fastball.
Yeah.
He needed a kind of a changeup, and he threw a dart. He just went a little bit too tall.
He was there. He was there for the pass, just didn't lead him.
McAllister was 6 out of 10 in the first half, and here in this third quarter, he is 3 out of 9. And they have pretty much just gone to passing. 3 out of three out of eight, I beg your pardon.
And here is McAllister on the quarterback keeper.
He had it. Let's see. Yep, they're going to give it to him. I was going to say, well, he had
right
it,
there.
And he was kind of slung backwards.
Yeah.
I think that was Stacy.
Forward momentum.
Yep.
Was it?
Yep, that was Stacy.
Connor Stacy lined up in the Wildcat. Does get just enough yardage for that first down just beyond the 30-yard line. They gave him his momentum there. Under a minute remaining in the third quarter, down to 50 seconds. McAllister back in at quarterback. Out of the pistol this time. And there's a big hole up the middle for the sophomore, Brady Noyes.
Yeah, nice run.
Yeah. Across the 35 to the 36-yard line.
That's what will happen. If you throw it, what's it going to do? It's going to open up some lanes. And that time it opened up a big running lane for Brady Noyes. You know, Brady's dad grew up and went to high school at County Line, so you expect him to be this big-time basketball kid, and instead he's going to end up being a really good football player for 3 years.
Does he play basketball?
He does. He does, okay. But he's a really, really good football
dad,
player.
Dad would be really disappointed if he didn't.
That's going to be the end of your
third
quarter.
Not that he wouldn't be proud of his football accomplishments.
Right,
that's the end of the third quarter. You're right. With Alma continuing to lead Farmington, 8-3, we are back with the fourth and final quarter coming up. Stay with us. Here again next week for the first round of the playoffs. Had to be away tonight. And filling in here at the last minute is McAllister Keefs over that left side. And he is close to another first down, about a yard away.
Well, this can be a big third down. Alma came in tonight averaging 34.5% on third down conversions. That's not where you want it to be in high school. McAllister threw three quarters, 9 out of 16, one pick, and 119 yards.
Dual receivers to the left side, single back, and this is, again, the keeper for McAllister. He's got the first down and more across the 45 to the 47-yard line.
Well, that's a big play. Keep the chains moving.
Had the blockers with the lead H-back blocking up front. Got him to the 48-yard line.
That's a 9-yard run. That's his longest run tonight. He's had four carries here in the second half for 17 yards.
The twin receivers. Now there's a man in motion. Fake the jet sweep. McAllister back. Short pass. Caught at the 43-yard line.
Yep, that's Connor Stacy.
Connor Stacy with the reception. Hanging on. The clock still rolls as he stays in bounds.
Boy, I don't know how that's not a first down. It's right on the marker, but it's going to be a 9-yard pass. And that's going to be a big play for Connor Stacy and another chance for another first down.
Again, faking the jets. No, they do go with the jet sweep this time. This is to Brady Noyes coming out of the slot position, and he's got some running room to the 40, about a 3-yard pickup.
Yep, he's going to keep the chains going. And the Airedale's trying to get this thing down the field, extend that lead, and the bigger thing is to keep the Cardinals away from the football.
Jimmy Haas should be back next week.
I've had a lot of fun tonight.
To the last moment, yeah. But yeah, Kevin and I jumping in. helping him out. You're wondering why it sounds so good this evening. Back, McAllister, toss left side, incomplete. As that was actually closer to being picked off than it was getting the reception.
It's almost like he wound up and threw that thing and then wanted to take it back. It's kind of tough for a high school kid. Well, it's tough at any level to throw across the field like that. Tom Brady can't do that every time. Aaron Rodgers can't do that every time. That's a tough play to make. Reagan Birchfield has checked in for the first time in the backfield.
Second and 10 from the 10-yard line. H-back in motion, single set back. Hand off up the middle, and this is the other sophomore coming in. This is Reagan Birchfield with the carry, and carrying, folks, got a nice run.
He did.
That's his first carry tonight, right?
First carry for 9 yards by the sophomore.
Not bad.
Reagan Birchfield, they got some pieces coming back in 2021. You've got your quarterback, your go-to receiver is coming back. You've got those really good sophomores, Brady Noyes and Reagan Birchfield.
I like those running backs built close to the ground. 5'9" for Birchfield and just a sophomore. With all the glory ahead of him. Here is a keeper by McAllister. Over on the left side, he'll get across the 30 down to the 28-yard line. And that was enough for another Alma first down. 9 minutes to play in regulation. Alma wanting to keep the clock rolling and keep this drive going.
That's five carries in this second half for the quarterback, McAllister, and two of those have been converted for first downs.
McAllister takes the handoff, tossed down. There is nobody there. No one there. I don't know who that was intended for, but there was no one. There was supposed to be somebody making a post pattern, and it was thrown over the middle on a quick toss, and
somebody
there was only
not,
Farmington guys close.
Yeah, somebody ran the wrong pattern, the wrong route, but now you've got second down.
It was a quick toss, kind of a rainbow post pattern, but again, no one there for Alma.
You know, the easiest thing to do is to call plays from the from your living room sofa in the press box. That's a hard thing to do.
Yeah. Out of the pistol, the offset pistol there.
And we got
the
a flag.
Play is blown dead. There is a motion call on Alma.
Well, now you've got, let's see if you can get this, pick up some chunks in two plays, second down and 15. So you were at the 28, now you're at the 33.
Twin receivers to the right. Birchfield in the backfield, fake handoff. This is the same play he did again. Yeah, he's got a man out there, and incomplete, overthrown.
Oh, they got a flag.
Yeah, they got the interference. You're exactly right. As Connor Stacey was there, it looked like Connor Stacey may have held up, could have kept running through it, but he may have been held up as well. So
these officials are going to talk it over, and let's see if they're going to get the interference. I don't know if that's an automatic first down. It's not a spot foul in high school. Yep, that's going to be a first down.
Yeah, I think if it was a holding, it may not have been, but they did call pass interference.
Should be a first down. Yep, it is at the 18-yard line. Yeah.
First and 10, Alma. 8:28 to play. Here in the fourth quarter. Starting to get late into this game. Again, Birchfield stays in out of the pistol. And he gets the handoff on that right side. Not a lot there. Maybe gets a yard. Maybe.
Not a lot. Good job on defense that time by the Cardinals for plugging this thing up. I think you got about a yard.
They get him, give him a yard. Second down and 9 at the 17.
Before tonight, Birchfield has had some carries on offense. He's had the he had some carries against the in the Clarksville ball game a few weeks back.
Okay. Twin receivers to the right, man in motion.
It's Stacy.
The jet sweep, you're right, out of the Wildcat. And he escapes a tackle. Stacy still on his feet inside the 10, down to the 8-yard line. He's close to the first down.
It's like riding a bull.
Yeah, he was not going down easy. Escaped one tackle, and they were still trying to bring him down. Finally did sling him down at the 8.
First and goal.
That is a first down. First and goal for the Airedales.
That's a heck of a run by Connor Stacy.
7:33, and the clock is rolling. Out of the Wildcat. Connor Stacy, and he's going to be in the Wildcat again. Stacy's still back there. Makes the jet sweep again, right up the middle is Stacy, and he slipped. Yep, at the but he did pick up yardage down to the 6.
Wow, making a cut, and he slipped and fell.
Now they're going to mark him at the 7. Mark him at the 7, second goal, so a yard pickup. McAllister is back in the huddle, so I assume he'll still stay. He'll be back in the quarterback.
Yep.
But it still looks like maybe a design quarterback run, and it is. Right up the middle, they had the blocker stacked for him, and out comes a late flag. Let's see what that's about.
Well, that's usually from the umpire. That's in the holding. The neighborhood of holding. Let's see what they call.
You can almost tell where they've got two fullbacks lined up there behind the tackle and the guard. And when they've been in that alignment before, it's almost you can almost tell that the quarterback's getting ready to run it.
Chop block.
Chop block.
Yeah, Lee, that's a tough one. That's a big one. Yeah, Lee, that's a 15-yarder.
Whoa.
Mercy.
Come on.
So now you're back at the 22.
Yeah, for a third down or second down and goal. I guess they'll replay the down. Yeah,
yep,
second and goal.
Well, they're going to call it the 21.
Yeah.
Wow.
Second down and goal from the 21-yard line. Yeah, that hurts. But let me ask you, is this in Dane Martin's range if they don't make it?
It's close. But keep in mind, your lead is 5, so if he gets a field goal out of this drive, the lead is 8. So they would have to obviously score a touchdown and then go for 2. But, wow, it's a tough call. It's two weeks in a row they've had chop block calls, and I don't know that I've seen that much in the last 15 or 20. I've not seen that much at all.
Timeout called, 8-3. Alma leads it. Big second and goal coming up from the 21 when we return in 1 minute. Back in Alma's second and goal from the 21 after the chop block. McAllister, now there's men in motion. You got trips to the left side stacked. Twins to the right side stacked. And here's a toss over the middle.
Oh,
He had him open and overthrew the intended receiver, Braden Allen. He was there, though.
Well, that is a tough, tough, tough break. So now you're third down. That's a touch play. And that's just a practice play, a touch. Got to have some timing on it. Just overthrew.
All right, here comes a big third and goal from the 21. Looking over the middle, a quick slant toss. It gets him down to the 12-yard line, 13-yard line. Caught. And this looks like relevant.
Yep.
Nehemiah Relliford with the catch. Asking him 12 and 24 brothers, and no, they are not, McAllister and Waylon. But they are both 6'7". Waylon and So here we go. This is going to be a 30-yard field goal attempt.
Yep.
Coming up for Dane Martin. See if this is his range. And now timeout. And this is by Farmington taking the timeout, so we'll take it with him. We're back with that field goal in 1 minute. No question, Steph. Three-yard field goal attempt. This is Dane Martin. Snap. Oh, and they bobble the snap. And Martin tries to pick it up. And we're back on the radios. Those of you watching saw it happen, but they fumbled the snap on the field goal attempt. It was bobbled by the holder. Dane Martin tried to pick it up and was tackled, so Farmington will take over on downs.
Mercy. Well, I'll tell you, this game.
At the 19.
Farmington with 5 minutes, 35 seconds left, as they still have life.
Yeah.
Plenty of life.
That would have been that field goal would have been huge for the Airedales if he had hit it. Here is Sutton on the roll, left side, throwing on the run, and incomplete. Stops the clock. A few times we've had the clock stop.
Yeah, this has been a really, really quick ball game. We're not even 9 o'clock, and we're about 5.5 minutes left.
The clock is rolled. They've kept it on the ground.
Yeah.
Both teams have. That was a good drive for Alma. Again, Alma had gotten the big play. The biggest play was the chop block. They had it second goal at the 7-yard line, and the chop block backed them up to the 21, and they did not recover from that 15-yard penalty.
They called a penalty on that, so they're going to back them up 5 yards to the 14.
Okay.
So first down and 15.
Back out of the I formation. It looks like Kane is back in there at the tailback, and he gets the handoff.
Yep, nice run.
The 15, now comes another late flag.
Wow.
Another late flag.
There's a flag on the field.
Officials are discussing it.
Shot block on Farmington.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Had a really had a chance to get to know Rusty Bush, his first year as the Alma coach. A super, super guy. Is from a native of Fordyce.
Oh.
Have you heard of Fordyce?
I have. Legendary Bear Bryant. We've got some great coaches that come out of Fordyce. The Red Bugs.
Yep. They had a good football team in 2020, but he is a super guy. And he's going to do some good things here. He's got a good staff. And, again, he's kind of been behind it because of all the crazy stuff that's happened.
Coached at Northside last year,
yeah,
right?
He did for a long time. He was with Jeff Williams down at El Dorado. And, of course, he went to college at Henderson State, where everybody, all coaches go, it seems like.
From the 6-yard line where they back it up, here's a quick toss. It was caught by Devontae Donovan. He'll run for some extra yardage, and yet another flag coming out. A couple of flags.
Well,
late.
The back judge, way.
It was something when the tackle was being made.
Yep.
Let's see. Hey, waiting for the call from the official. It's a personal foul. A face mask on Alma. They'll get that 15 yards back.
And then some. It's going to be a first down.
All the way up to the 29-yard line.
Wow.
5:19, the clock is stopped. Yeah, they got some extra yardage because the pass was caught and it came at the end of the tackle. Single back. And now the handoff, and this is Kane across the 30. down to the 34-yard line. Kane Taylor on the run.
He's really become a kind of a feature back. He's had a lot of carries. Late.
Well, they started again. Anybody watching from Farmington, which I know one is, Ian Cartwright, who is a backup quarterback, started as running back. He's been doing pretty well. Their normal starter is out. Concussion call. Here's a handoff on that right side. And Taylor gets back to the line of scrimmage. That's it.
Just a nice tackle by Landon Burkhart.
Big third down coming up.
It is.
Third down and about four needed. They need to get to the 39.
Almost under 4 minutes, so really this is probably two down territory.
Yeah. Short drop, Sutton. Toss out in the flat. First down at the 45 and brought down immediately there.
Nothing fancy, just a 10-yard out and moving the chains. So Farmington, boy, huge play on the personal foul face mask. 1 minute you're at the 7, and the next thing you're almost at midfield.
Yes. Donovan split out to the left side. Receivers to each side for Sutton out of the pistol. Rolling to the right side is Sutton. Looking, he makes the toss, caught, and still on his feet at the 30. What a catch.
What a throw.
It was. He was directing traffic as he was scrambling, but Elliot Thompson with the catch down to the 29-yard line of Alma.
Well, 31-yard pass play. Kind of a wheel route.
Yep.
He kind of told him where he was going to put it, and he put it on the money.
He told him, he was directing, go down. You know, they were just making it up as they went along, and he made the over-the-shoulder catch and run down to the 29. Here is Taylor, straight ahead, still on his feet, down to the 25.
Nice run.
Once again, penalty big on this drive.
Yep.
As Alma had the face mask. Otherwise, Farmington was facing another third down and long.
Boy,
that kept him going.
Yeah, and the tough thing is the penalty came from so far back. Just a really, really, really tough play. That kind of defines what's happened.
Out of the I formation, and this is the fullback.
That's Cartwright.
This is Cartwright on the carry, and he is still struggling for yardage. Gets down to the 15.
First down.
This is the backup quarterback.
Yeah.
Who started at tailback. He's been playing fullback as well. They're having success running out of the eye, and he's down to the 15-yard line. Another first down for the Cardinals. And the clock is down to 2:18 remaining in the game. This may be the ball game, this whole drive here.
Yeah, this might be.
See if the Alma defense stiffens up here.
Quarterback looks like he might be changing the play. Nope, waiting for his running back to tie his shoe.
Yep, Taylor was tying his shoe. Here he gets the toss, left side, on the sweep. Cuts it up at the 25, at the 15, at the 10, down to the 8-yard line.
Wow.
He needs to get to the 5 for the first. Yeah, I'm going to go out on the limb and say this is going to be the ball game, folks.
Yeah, we're under 2 minutes left. And you've almost got a first and goal situation. Now they're walking back.
We had a
holding. Okay.
Had a hold on Farmington.
Wow, that's a big
Farmington,
penalty.
That is a big penalty. So now they are looking at first down.
Wow.
From the...
It's back at the 27-yard
line. Because you mark it from where the hole took place, and it was in the backfield as he was going on that sweep.
First and
22. Back, Sutton rolling to the right, escapes one tackle.
Oh, they're going to get a face mask.
Oh, they are. They're going to get some of this yardage back.
Wow.
As slashing in front. Was that Burkhart?
Yeah, it was Burkhart. He's kind of reached out in trying to grab the jersey. I think he might have grabbed the helmet.
Yeah, that face mask, that's going to get 15 yards back. Boy, we're going to have some drama here at the end, folks.
Wow.
We are going to have some drive. We're going to have one of these crazy finishes here. 15-yard line is where they'll mark it. It's still a first down and 10. They still have to get to the 5-yard line.
Well, it's back to where it was. Right, it was first and 15, and now it's first and 15 again.
That's right. Single back, and that's Cronister. He gets the carry. Trying to bounce it to the outside. He does.
Oh,
at the 10. Here comes another flag, but Cronister's into the end zone. Let's see what the flag is.
Well, Cartwright's in, but there's going to be a block in the back.
May have the clip.
Yep, or the old clipping penalty. Wow.
Nice piece of running, though, by Cronister, as he was able to bounce it to that left side.
Yep.
And get down the sidelines and into the end zone. But the Farmington coaches are next to me, and they are just exasperated right now. That didn't work.
Wow.
So that's going to back them up to the 24-yard line.
I think it's safe to say we've had more penalty yards in the last fourth quarter than we've had total yards
in
the fourth quarter.
8-3 is our score.
Yeah.
There's only 1:03 remaining. And
wow.
Another flag down.
This may be a sideline warning. Let's see if it's a penalty. He's going to tell us. Yep.
So, they're actually good. It's not a warning. They're calling it.
Well, normally you get the old warning, and I don't know if I've heard a warning tonight, but now it's back at the 39. This game's like a wild roller coaster.
Now, folks, you are back at the 39-yard line with 1:03 remaining.
Wow.
8-3 our score. Alma leading Farmington, trying to hold on. They actually had a score called back because of a clip. Here is a toss left side, caught and out of bounds at the 27.
Are they going to say he caught it out of bounds or in bounds?
No, he caught it and then out of bounds. I'm sorry.
Nope, they're going to say out of bounds.
He caught it out.
Yeah.
They're saying that.
Yep.
That brings
up
second down.
Okay, so. Second down and third. Second down and 30. They still need to get to the 5-yard line for a first down. They're at the 39. 58 seconds now remaining.
Yeah, you're under a minute left. Timeout situation. Alma has one. Farmington has two.
Alma trying to hold on for the home crowd tonight. Twin receivers to the right. Sutton back. A lot of time. Looking. He's going to throw it deep down the right side. Intercepted at the 20, 25.
Trey Fuesler.
At the 30. Fuesler at the 40 at midfield. Flags are down as he gets it down to the 32-yard line of Farmington.
Wow.
The third interception for him tonight. How about that?
Well, the ball was underthrown big time. Maybe Trey ought to be a receiver. He's caught three passes.
Let's see what the flag is.
It's going to be a block in the back.
It was on the return. You're right.
It's going to be a block in the back, but it's going to be Alma football. And with 42 seconds left, man, oh, man.
No interceptions for Alma's defense all year. Three tonight, all by the same guy.
It's not Jimmy Haas. It's Marty Houston.
Absolutely. I'll take credit for that. Give me that game ball.
Oh, that's crazy. They might. We have a player shaking up after this penalty, or after the penalty in the break.
Yeah, it's an Alma player, it looks like. No, it is. It's a Farmington player, sorry. Yeah. It is number 72, Andrew Wood, that was shaken up. He's walking off on his own power, though. Yeah, no question. Sutton did not get enough arm on that one. He was looking to throw deep and lead, and it was underthrown, and Fuesler was right there with the pickoff. Huge interception for the Airedales.
It's amazing because he had the one kind of the wheel route earlier on that drive where just a gorgeous, perfectly put the ball on the receiver, and that one, not enough air.
That all the way down to the 33 of Farmington on the return.
Well,
offsetting. They called unsportsmanlike on the Farmington bench. They called the block in the back, so they offset. And the ball will remain at the 33-yard line.
Mike Adams is still, he's in the middle of the field.
He's fuming, yeah. He's still coming onto the field. He's still coming onto the field.
He's going to get his money's worth. Wow. You say you want to be a ref, or a basketball ref, or a football ref? No thanks. You know, in college, I did, when I was 19, about 40 years ago, by the way, I was umpired an intramural softball game. Didn't work out well because, every out was arguing.
I did youth league baseball umpiring one time.
Yeah.
One time, and that was enough for me.
Yep, hats off to, I got a lot of ref buddies, you do too.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of good ones out there.
Yes.
And mercy.
And we need good ones.
I mean,
they do it because they love the game.
Right, right.
They really do. I mean, and they try to recruit on the high school level officials all the time. And not everybody wants to do it because, you're not going to make a fortune doing officiating in high school football.
Guys are going to miss plays.
Yeah.
Basketball, you've heard this 1,000 times where a ref runs by the coach and says, hey, I missed that a minute ago.
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
Yeah.
You know, it's going to happen. Well, Alma's going to be in prevent here.
Yeah, they're going to be in the victory formation.
How about that?
42 seconds, and Alma's lining up in the victory formation here. They're going to kneel.
Rusty Bush going to get his first win.
Wow.
At home for the Alma Airedales. How about that?
Yeah.
What a crazy game.
Rogers earlier this year, and on the final game of the regular season, Alma is going to pitch the shutout. We had some fun there at the end, as you see McAllister just hugging his sophomore running back, who is about half of his size.
Yeah.
It looks like his son out there that he's hugging. But they're hugging him. They're going to pull off their second win and get a little momentum going in maybe to Texarkana next week.
Yep, that's going to do it. Hunter McAllister is hugging Jacob Corsi, and the Alma Airedales get that W.
Yeah, there they go. Coach Bush out there. He's got his arms in the air, and they're happy. It's been a while. It's been, since the third week that they've had the win? They had some games that have been put off, and to finish the regular season, get a win, good for Alma as they pull it off. 8-3, the final score, and fireworks going off here at Alma. We'll have a wrap-up for you when we return after this.
Band, cheer, dance, football, and all the support staff. Seniors, thank you for 3 great years. Ladies and gentlemen, please be careful going home. And remember, there's only one Airedale. Go, Alma! Thank you. Fort Smith for supporting our fireworks display tonight. Thank you, Jim Riggle Tire.
Okay. All right,
guys.